Thank you for listening to The Luminous Mind, episode 97.
The biggest negative thought that is out there is the feeling like you're not enough. And this can be in any area of your life, but just, I'm not enough.
Benjamin Franklin once said, "Do not curse the darkness, rather light a candle instead." If you're ready to set your mind on fire, then prepare yourself for The Luminous Mind with your host, Rebecca Bowman.
Today's Firestarter is Molly Harmison. Molly is a wellness mentor and trainer. She inspires individuals all over the nation to reach their full potential and break through the limiting beliefs that they are not enough. True success comes from the realization that you were put here for something great, but all too often, the greatness is stifled by negative beliefs about yourself. Through her own trials of getting to a place of complete numbness and almost losing her marriage, Molly inspires others to become the people they were truly meant to be. Molly uses mentoring tools and the tools of essential oils to help others break through those limiting beliefs and find hope, healing, and freedom in their lives, and in turn empower the lives of others around them. Come learn how to release what's been holding you back and equip yourself to move forward with correct tools and principles to help you accomplish your goals and heal your body and mind. You are enough, and there's enough goodness to go around, and you just need to learn how to attract it. Welcome, Molly.
Thank you. Glad to be here.
I'm excited to have you here. Do you want to tell our audience a little bit more about yourself and how you came to this mission and passion of helping others?
I will. I would love to. So a little bit about me. So I come from a really small town in Idaho, and I am number 6 of 9 kids. And So I think right off the bat, anybody that has a big family or is stuck in the middle somewhere in their family can relate to a little bit of my story of feeling like I needed to find my place. And I had a wonderful, wonderful childhood. My parents are just the best people that I know. But I also struggled a lot with my identity and not knowing who I was. And it just various things in my life took me to a place where, let's see, like when I got married, oh my word, I was married at 20, just barely 20. And, you know, I thought I knew who I was at 20.
I was married at that age too. And when you look at kids now, I'm like, oh my gosh, that's so young.
They seem like just babies, but I thought I had it all figured out, at least as a young single adult. But, you know, I think a lot of people can relate to this, but getting married, I had certain expectations or certain ideals that I thought I should be as a wife. And, you know, society kind of put some of that on us too. And I just had a lot of things that I thought I needed to be that weren't contradictory with my morals or my ethics or things like that. But just I found myself completely losing myself in my role as a wife. And then a mother, you know, having kids, like, bringing the equation in there.
Maybe like living up to other people's expectations of us, or is that what you're meaning?
I would say absolutely. Thinking, you know, I'm supposed to be this way, or, you know, and then even just having, you know, I wanted to be the best wife I could, and then feeling like I would fall short in this area or that area. Whatever it is, I think everyone has their own story in this, you know, after you get married. But for me, it took me to a place where I totally lost who I was. And my relationship with my husband really struggled, and we totally just kind of went separate ways emotionally, you know, like we're living in the same house, but we went down a really destructive path and chose some really destructive things for our marriage. And we almost lost it. We almost lost it. And that was a really hard time for me. And it was hard in a way that is probably different than what you might think. It was really hard and really hurtful in the beginning. But then the hardest part was when I went numb with it all. So it's like you think about, you experience pain on different levels, and what happens to your body, you know, when you, like, if you really get, like, hurt, if you got stabbed or something, and your body naturally starts to numb. And that's where I didn't even realize it, but where I started to go in my life was becoming just completely numb and not even knowing I was, first of all. And then when my marriage was totally taking just like turn for the worst and crashing, I remember feeling like, okay, I want something different. And that was huge for me. It might seem like so small for, as I say it now, but at the time when I was living in a place where I couldn't feel hurt, I couldn't feel joy, I couldn't feel happiness, you know, except for extremes, it was actually harder to come out of that place of numbness. I wanted to. I got to where I desired it. And then that's where the real roller coaster began. And so that's kind of a little bit about me, at least where I was in my life as of, gosh, it's only been about 5 years since I went through that. And then where I am today is really the complete opposite. That's why I feel so compelled and just totally humbled and also just totally excited to now share my story, because I know there are people out there, women in particular, but just people in general, that have experienced this and don't know how to get out of it.
Yeah. Well, and when you talk about that numbness that you feel and wanting to be something different, was it something different that you saw or something different than what was going on at that time? I mean, something like changing the past type of thing, or?
That's an excellent question. So really, I don't know about you, but I remember like as a little girl imagining who I would be when I grow up, you know, and what I would look like and, you know, just my life as an adult. And for me, like I got a pretty vivid picture of that, of who I wanted to be, and particularly like who I wanted to be married to. Like, oh, my husband will be this way and he'll do this for me. And oh, life will just be like this, you know? And I remember a youth leader one time telling me, you know, scratch that dream. That's not in a very nice way. Like basically like you need to prepare yourself for it to be work, you know, not for it to just be this blissful honeymoon all the time. But as a youth, I didn't understand that. And so when I say like wanting to be someone different, it's I realized in my life, this person that I wanted to be had become very dim. And my recollection of her was small. And I couldn't imagine, I just wasn't her. I wasn't her because I wasn't on an emotional and any even physical level, I wasn't this great person that I had set out to be. And that's where I wanted to change that.
Well, did you stop dreaming? Is that kind of the thing? I mean, when we're young, we do have a like this dream of, like you said, who we're going to become, and you know, trying to make that into reality sometimes is a difficult thing. And I don't know about you, but yeah, sometimes you get in the humdrum part of life and you just kind of stop dreaming about, mm-hmm. you know, who you want to be. Is that kind of where you were at, or was it different than that?
Absolutely right. That's what happened. I've always been a dreamer and things like that, but I'm also a go-getter. I'm like I dream it up, but I got to get it done. Like, what's the way to get this done? And when you fall into this state of just numbness, you know, and people will call it different things. They'll call it depression. They'll call it, you know, different things. And it is that. It is that. But when you don't allow yourself to feel the good and the bad, mostly the bad, and then the good comes along. You can't feel good either because you're blocking out the bad. The idea of dreaming is just not there. Yeah, it's just really, you're not even living in the present. So to dream about the future is pretty obsolete.
Wow. So how did you go about changing all of this and changing your mindset and your paradigm and saving your marriage and becoming who you are?
Well, first it was hitting complete rock bottom, which is a goal of mine now to help people before they get that low. but it really was. I mean, we were at the worst place possible. I was making the worst decisions possible for myself and my husband too. You know, we were just in a bad place. We hit this bottom, and I have to give so much of the credit to my amazing sweet husband, because he was the one to take the first step to say, we're going to do something about this. And I was so numb. I didn't want to be married anymore. I'm getting so real with you, and I hope that's okay.
Yeah, that's fine.
I didn't even really have feelings for him anymore, because I didn't have feelings about much of anything. Like I was a bad case of this, and there's so many different levels of it, but I was a bad case. And so I just remember him pushing for it. But if I can say what I did was first that desire for something different. And I've always been a spiritual person. I've always been a religious person. Even when I fell short, you know, in this area of my life, I knew it to be real. And it was deciding that I was going to use that power that I know to be so great, and finding a higher power. And for me, it's my Heavenly Father, it's God, you know, but for whatever it is for other people, that was the first place that I turned and started my journey with just being able to feel again, just being able to feel. And from there, I sought out mentors like you wouldn't believe. And that's just what really helped me, because I didn't know how to change. I wanted to change, but I didn't know how, and I needed direction in that way. And so, you know, just finding mentors and never going without one. I will never be without a mentor in my life again. Having somebody that's gone there first. And for me, I'm talking about personal development mentors. You know, there's lots of different mentors. I have mentors in, you know, for my nutrition and for my health and things like that. But what I'm talking about is specifically personal development mentors that have been there and can help me to know the next steps to take.
Well, and too many times we think we can do it all on our own, you know, and that we can fix ourselves. But give me your experience with working with a mentor and how that helped you change that paradigm or that philosophy.
Okay, so yeah, so I did a lot of work, like between me and just everything I knew how to do, I felt like I did it in like a year after us just saving what we had of our marriage and growing upon it. We did as much as we could. So you're absolutely right. Like we think we can do it all. And I got to this place where I felt some stagnance, and I never wanted to feel that again, you know? And so I'm like, okay, I'm so much better, but I'm feeling stagnant. And so I sought out a mentor. And the great thing about having a mentor is that he pushed me just enough and loved me just enough. You know, it's like he pushed on. If you imagine like getting a sliver and how painful that is. And then when someone touches that sliver and tries to pull it out, like that's really painful. But as soon as they get it, as soon as you get it, it's like you can touch it and there's no pain, right? Like there's just nothing. Yeah. It's like it's just totally gone. And that's the best way I describe my mentoring experience. And even to this day with my mentor that I have now, and then that's what I do too, is like you push on the, or you get the sliver out, but you're pushing on it a little and it is painful and it is kind of, it might make you a little mad. But then it's like you get to it, you get it out, and it's like you remember it no more. And that is just, I guess that's the best visual I can come up with, what it's like to have a mentor and just seeing myself become somebody that I never even visualized. So that's what's so awesome. Like I told you how, you know, I had this idea of who I wanted to be and things like that. And now I'm at a place like I couldn't even visualize this girl on my own.
Like, I didn't even like know. Way better than.
Yeah, I didn't even know I could exist. And it's all because I've had mentors to show me that it's possible, to show me the way.
That is awesome. Yeah. So how have you in turn came around and helped other people? What are you doing now?
Well, so I am, like I said, a wellness mentor, and I mentor people, both personal mentoring and group mentoring. And that's where we go first. We target your identity first, because I feel like as we work on who you are, then we can gain direction, the direction you want to go, and create clarity for what it's going to take to get there. So I always have my mentees have some kind of goal. And it's like your why for now, you know, why are you here for right now? And then, of course, it can evolve. But I work with people. The biggest negative thought that is out there is the feeling like you're not enough. And this can be in any area of your life. But just I'm not enough is the thought that plagues the human race. And that's the thought that we attack. If I can show you as a mentor enough evidence that you're enough and you can get to where you believe it, we can together decide your direction and create clarity for that. It's a beautiful process. And so I have different programs that I do. I have personal mentoring is I do the most of, just one-on-one. You know, people really like that because it's all unique to them. We go from there. I have group mentoring where I lay out basically my secrets to success, my recipes of how I got to where I was, to where I am now. And those are appointments that we do all as a group. And I just map it out for you. I love that one. And then I have specific classes and trainings that I do. One of them that I love is we talk about your emotions and how your emotions are leading to your physical ailments. Your emotions about your past, present, and future are aiding some of these physical ailments that you're feeling in your body. And so that's a pretty deep class, but I love that one. And then another one that my husband and I do, which is probably one of our most popular ones, we do a class called Improving Communication. So my husband is a professional stand-up and improv comedian. He travels all over the world making people laugh. And it's just, he's got the coolest job. And I started doing improv with him back when, so when we were like, okay, we're going to get on track with each other. And we wanted to just do something together. You know, that's what you hear. And that's what our marriage counselor said to do. That's what you hear and read in books and things. It's like, okay, find something you can do together. So we started doing improv comedy together. And I, as I think just a natural mentor, I started to notice some of these principles that we were learning in doing improv comedy and how they can apply to life and your connection and communication with people in your life. And so we put together a class where we use those principles and we play games and make it really interactive. But it's a couples class and it's called Improving Communication. And yeah, we work with couples to help their communication become better and their connection become stronger. So that's just kind of an outline of some different things that I do, but I just love it because I can hit so many different areas. But I would say that number one place in every type of mentoring that I do, we work on your identity and build up from there.
Before we go on, let us take a minute and hear about our sponsors. Changing a paradigm takes some study, but like me, you are probably super busy. That's why we've teamed up with Audible. Go to our website, theluminousmind.net. Get a free month of Audible with 2 audiobooks, thousands of titles, in exchange for only books that you absolutely love. You too can be learning on the go to keep that fire burning. Back to the Luminous Mind with Molly Harmison. That's awesome. So Do you feel like with the improv, the humor of it actually helps the marriages too?
It is vital. It is so vital. And that's what I love about this class, because we are not therapists. We don't dig deep down into your issues, things like that. But we bring up the emotions inside of you, and in a very safe atmosphere where you two then are able to connect. But having this fun side to it, it makes it so much, it just makes the connection stronger, because you're not coming at it from a negative place or anything like that. And then it's really great because you leave there with tools you can use when you get home. You know, just tools, just different exercises that it's like, hey, honey, you know how they talk to us about listening and how we're supposed to listen, and we did that exercise. Maybe we should just try that exercise again, and just things like that. So it's very useful. It's not just like a fun weekend, you know, with each other. You get to go home and have tools to use later on to help improve your marriage.
Yeah.
And it's all just fun.
And sometimes when we see something that's lighthearted, not sarcastic necessarily, but lighthearted, that we do, we want to work on it and we keep striving towards that. Or what's your opinion on that?
No, I think you're absolutely right. I think one of the biggest things that in doing a communication class, one of the biggest things I've found is people will say, well, I have a good marriage, so I don't know if your class is for me. Those are the people I love working with the most, because people that have a good marriage coming to a class like this, then it makes you go to the next level. It's like I said, in imagining who I was and now becoming this person that I didn't even know existed. You think your marriage is good before, wait till you come to something like this, and it just gets better. But it's not come at in a, it's come at in such a positive way that when people understand that, it's like, oh yeah, I could do that. You know, I thought maybe you were gonna like, it was for only people that are, you know,
really struggling
with being like a therapist or something. Like I said, we are not therapists. We just know how to communicate. We have learned, we've gone through it, and we now know just how to share what we know. And it's brilliant. It's awesome. I just love it.
That's great. So what successes have you seen with your message?
Okay, so that's a great question. I actually got a text. This was actually just, oh man, a couple days ago. And I might even just read it. Do you care if I read it to you?
No, that sounds great.
I might as well take it right from the source. And this is somebody, I mean, I guess this is switching gears a little bit. This wasn't from our improving communication class, but this is a personal mentee of mine that sent this text. And I just love it. The best testimonials come when you don't expect them, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
And so, okay, so this is what he says. He said, I stayed going back down into a cycle. And I teach people about cycles because that's really, just to say that, to talk to you about it really quick. When you keep having the same thing happen to you, the same bad stuff in different, either different people keep hurting you the same way, or you keep having these negative cycles through your life. It's literally because that is what you are choosing to travel. And it's only because you don't know how to break it. And so I love working with people on breaking your cycles. And this is what I had worked with this gentleman on. And so he said, he's telling me that he stayed going back down in a cycle, you know? So he's bringing up that hard first. And then he says, but what you taught me really helped. I realized I had some control and there was things I could do to pull myself out of the cycle quicker. It has made me realize that I have to take some responsibility for how I feel. I cannot just be a victim of how I'm feeling. That's really been empowering. I have finally gotten through 4 names on my anchor list. And this is something else he's talking about. I do relationship training, how to heal relationships. And so he's basically saying he's healed 4 relationships in his life. And then he says, I really had a lot of nastiness inside of me. I thought it would be exhausting to go through this process, but it is actually very energizing. Thank you so much for your help. So that was just awesome to get that. I mean, I get them. That's a small, you know, message that maybe only took him just a few minutes to send. But what it does for me is I get to know you on such a great, you know, personal level that when I see your success, I rejoice with you in a way that it's like I want your success more than you do, really. At least it starts out that way. And when I see you, like, see this picture and actually the world starts to open up, it's the coolest thing ever. So I have...
Well, and it sounds like you're really teaching people to own their, you know, their emotions, like he said. I mean, we are in kind of this victim mentality world anymore that we just want to blame all of our problems on somebody else. Do you teach a lot about your own responsibility in healing yourself?
Yeah, it's really, it's so important. Because when you think about, like, if things are always done to you, you have no control over that, right? Like, you might as well just lay down and let life take its course. And that's what people do choose to do. What happens when you take ownership for your actions is you feel where you need to change. And that's sometimes a really scary place. And so if we can blame someone else, then it takes the attention off of us. But the detriment to that is you lose control, right? Like,
yeah.
I have no control over a situation. How am I ever able to really think that there'll be any great outcome of it? So one of my very favorite statements that I use all the time is, if I'm the problem, I'm the solution. And so anything that you experience in your life, and I know there are certain things that are beyond your control, but we always have control of the way we act towards it, our emotions behind it. And if you can get to a place where you can understand how to deal with your emotions in a positive way by turning it inward, there is no problem you cannot solve. There is no wall you can't get over. There's nothing that you can't achieve if you turn it around to yourself and walk the path and realize that I can see my problem in this, which is great. I have control of that. I don't have control of what other people do or say, but I know what I can do or say. And that piece right there is mind-blowing with what you can attract in your life just by you changing your cycles that have caused negative outcomes in your life before.
Well, and when you feel like you have no control, you also feel like you have, I mean, there's no happiness there. Like you said, you do have to go numb, you know, because that's how you deal with it. But then you short yourself of the joy that you get, too.
Yeah, absolutely.
Even dealing with the pain and stuff, even though that's painful to have to deal with that because you're feeling some emotion, it causes a better feeling. What would you say about that?
Well, yeah, like a visual that I will give people is, imagine like you have a 5-gallon bucket and there is so mud that has dried into, like, you know, just the dirt that it's like you can barely even chip away at it, right? And let's say there's a good like 4 inches of it in this 5-gallon bucket. How would you clean that? Like, what first comes to your mind as to how would you clean that?
Just pour a bunch of water in, I guess.
Absolutely. You'd pour a bunch of water in because you want to break it up and turn it into mud. So what happens when you pour a bunch of water in, and let's say we start stirring it around, that stuff is going to kind of come to the surface, right?
Yeah.
It's going to start to have just this mess first before it gets better, right?
Yeah.
Turn it up, all of it's coming up to the surface. It's like, okay, this is a mess. But then you dump it out, rinse the bucket out, and your bucket's clean. So you're going to experience, in experiencing change and growth, you're always going to experience pain. But it's pain in the right direction, right? Like if I'm cleaning this bucket by dumping the water in it and it's just a mess at first, it's still going in the right direction.
Yeah.
So the pain that you feel is for a purpose, all in the right direction to then be able to dump out your bucket and you're totally clean.
Wow. So what advice or encouragement would you give to somebody who's kind of wanting to start out in this path of changing their life around?
the first advice I would give is be willing to accept yourself first the way that you are, and know that you are who you are for a reason, and then be willing to look at yourself inwardly as to how you can change. And then from there, just being willing, you don't have to know how you can change, just being willing to say, okay, I'm ready to change. I'm ready for something bigger and better in my life. And then from there, absolutely seeking out a mentor, someone that can help you along the way, because you need to work on your identity. If you don't know who you are, you'll never know what you can become.
Yeah. And a mentor maybe stops the denial process. Is that why you encourage that so much?
Yeah. The mentor, there's no excuses with a mentor. They are a third party that has no emotional connection with the people around you. And they've already walked in those steps. So they know what it takes to get it done. And so they can be the person to, like I said, push you enough and love you enough. Push you enough and love you enough. And when you can do that, that's actually the get it done way. You know, you can take things in and be like, oh, that's so great. Okay, I'm going to go do that. And that will get you to some extent. So that's really great, really powerful. Any books you can read or seminars you can attend and things like that, it's in the right direction. But you reach a point where your own beliefs, your own knowledge gets you as far as it can go, and you need someone that has traveled the distance that can step in and say, this is the next step. And yeah, it's just a step. It's not a big, huge wall. We think it is, because we think our problems and troubles are all just, we're the only ones that experience it. And it's so hard. And a mentor helps you to realize that it is just a step we have to get over, and we can find greater success on the other side.
That is great. Well, and if you have a spiritual bent to you, you know, in the council of two or more witnesses or something like that, that you're able to find wise solutions to those answers.
Absolutely.
I am totally slaughtering the scripture, but something like
that. I know what you mean.
So if you could leave a legacy, what would it be?
Oh, that is a cool question. I would love for people to understand that the trials in your life that you think have caused all of your problems have really made you the beautiful person that you are. And that's heavy. That's deep, I know. But so often we blame the things that have happened to us in our lives on why we are the way we are, or why so-and-so is the way they are. And in reality, those trials have made you the great person you are. If I didn't go through what I went through in my childhood, in my high school years, in my college years, and in my marriage, I wouldn't be this person. In fact, if I didn't go through the hard stuff that I went through as a child, I know this because I have done my own personal, you know, prayers and different things. I have gotten this answer clear that I know if I hadn't have gone through the things I did as a child, I would not have met and actually been attracted to my husband. And therefore, I would not have married him, and I would not be the person I am today. And so how can I ever look at anything in my life as something that was just done to me, and how could I not, or, you know, like, why was this done to me? Now, granted, of course you are doing that when you go through it, but I want to leave a legacy that shows people that who you are is exactly who you need to be for your mission here on this life, and in what is in store for you in the next life.
That is
that
great.
What you have is what you need.
That's so anything negative can be turned into a positive, basically.
Anything negative, we can rewrite the stories by rewriting our emotions about the stories. And from there, we are not in bondage to them anymore. And we can look at any situation in our life and heal from it and find hope that there's something better, find healing in the power of going the distance, and then freedom that it no longer has, we are not in bondage to it at all.
That is awesome. Oh, thank you. So before we say goodbye, do you have any final parting words of advice or maybe a favorite quote you'd like to share? And then please give us your contact information so our audience can get in touch with you.
Yeah, I just love helping people. And I think the best advice I can give is to love people, but first you have to learn to love yourself, you know? And so that's where I would go the distance with you as a mentor, as a trainer, anything like that. I'm just here because I know I'm supposed to help people. And that's where I'm going. I'm sure you've heard the quote before of our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate, but powerful beyond measures. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us. And that in a world, you know, we're all meant to shine. And it's so true. Sometimes we get scared when we get a glimpse of who we could be. So we shun away. And that's sometimes even more scary, feeling like we aren't enough. We attach the negative belief that we're not enough because we're afraid to go the distance. And I am telling you, I will go the distance with you or any mentor that you feel attracted to go to. They'll go the distance with you. And it becomes a beautiful thing. I would love, is there a way that I can give away?
Oh, yeah.
Gifts on here?
That'd be great. Do you want me to just attach a link to your show notes page?
Yeah, I would love that. I have a CD, and it is called Becoming the Girl of My Dreams. And it includes my story and how I became that person I always dreamt of being and how I realized who she was and that I was her. And I give specific tools for you on how to get there yourself, how to first dream it up if you haven't before. You know, if you're not like me and didn't dream vividly of who you wanted to be when you grew up.
Or maybe you stopped dreaming.
Or maybe you absolutely. Wherever you're at in that dream, I bring that up and out and I give you the tools that I did. They're just the things that I did to get there so that you can become that person you always wanted to be. And it's called Becoming the Girl of My Dreams, but I will tell you, I've had as many men as women listen to this.
That's funny.
The same rules do apply. I would love to give a CD away someone that, I don't know, maybe just the first person to comment. How's the best way to make that work?
Oh, yeah. They could definitely go into YouTube and leave a comment under the video that we do for you.
So
that would be great.
Yeah, I would love to leave it to the first person to comment and include who you are today. Just a little brief, like who you are today. And I would love to send a free copy of my CD to you. And then also, I love giving things away. So this is a place. I would also love to give, I have a group, I told you about my group mentoring package. And this is basically about a 2-month mentoring experience with me. And we do calls. It's a call every other week. And it's an hour and a half call. And you're on with the whole group. It's a conference call. And I walk you through my steps of success. And I would love, so this, I'll just tell you right now, this retails, like if you go on and purchase this, it retails for $2,700.
Wow.
And I would love to give one away.
That'd be great. Is there a way that they can contact you on your website and just mention that they heard it on our show, The Luminous Mind?
Let's just do it. I would love actually for it to just go straight to my email. If you will email Hope, Healing, and Freedom.
Hope, Healing, and Freedom.
At gmail.com. And you tell me that you heard about the offer for the group mentoring on the Luminous Mind podcast, and I will give you a ticket to that. That would be awesome.
That is awesome. I'll have to check it out myself and look at it. So that sounds great. Well, I really appreciate it. Did you give us your contact information, website, or anything like that?
My contact information, just I do most of it through email. My website is totally under construction right now. So if you go there, you'll get lost between stuff. The best way to get a hold of me is just that Gmail, hopehealingandfreedom@gmail.com. And you can email me any questions about when are your upcoming events and things like that. And I will get a hold of you that way. That's going to be the best as at this point.
Okay, well, I will definitely link your email onto your show notes page, so definitely check that out and check Molly out. You've really given me a lot of hope. It's just been a wonderful, positive call. I really appreciate you taking the time to join us and wish you the best in success.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you for listening to The Luminous Mind. To learn more about Molly and to get her offers, go to our show notes at theluminousmind.net. Be sure to become a subscriber to our free email list and consider joining our program by going to the scheduling tab to become a fire starter today. Help support the podcast by making all your Amazon purchases through the free Amazon widget on our website. Also, sign up to receive 2 free audiobooks from Audible at theluminousmind.net. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, Google+, and now Pinterest. Get our audio content by subscribing on YouTube, iTunes, and Stitcher. To help us grow, consider telling your friends about us. Leave us a review. Tell us how we can help you so together we can continue to light minds on fire and change the paradigm of education